Today I'm going to show you the IH-19. It's strange, but you see on the internet the same quadcopter, but then it's got another name. But this one is the YH-19. A very sturdy box. You see someone has sit on it, I guess. But the drone is still intact. You get remote control, and remote control is similar like the remote control from the DJI Spark, but this one has this feature. You can put the phone like this. And I also saw a drone made by Asheen, and they got exactly the same remote control. You got the trim buttons there and there, on and off switch, headless mode, and return to home. Well, the return to home is not that it's coming back on this spot where you start the drone, but when you fly that way, it comes back in that direction. So when it's left or right from you, it goes back, but not, it will not come to you, but it's reversed. So when you fly to the east and you fly a bit to the north, then when you push this button, it will fly from that place to the west. There is a speed switch, and here you got a flip switch and the shutdown switch, so the motors will stop immediately. You have to be careful for that, because when you want to do the flips, I saw that in some videos, if you want to do the flips and you push the wrong button, it drops out of the sky. Buff. This is the automatic takeoff, and this is automatic landing. That's about it. And then you can leave this so, like this, because this is just for show. These are not antennas, you see, there's no wiring whatsoever. And here is the actually quadcopter. It's strange because I think here is something missing, because I saw a video with the same quadcopter, and here was a little plate similar like the front of the Spark. The camera is adjustable, you see. You can turn it high and low to the ground. It's a pretty quality camera, so the footage is okay. It's a foldable drone, you see. And it's a battery. There's just a battery inside, a little one. And you can charge it with a micro USB cable. That's this one. And also two spare props. And prop guards for flying inside. So shielding lights, red light on the back, and on the front there's no light, but just the blue light on the legs. It will not save the footage on your phone, but it has a SD slot here. You put an SD card in there, and that will record all the footage. So here I have the app, and it's recording, you see. So these are all the features. This is the photo, this is video, which you can also use by clicking here, and you can click, I think here, one of these is the speed rates, but you have them here also, you see, 60, 130%. But here is also the photo, and this is video, but I did not try it. I used these two buttons. And the rest I have to play with it first, because I have not used these things, but I'm gonna do that and show you in another video. It's nice that you can adjust the camera so you can make these kind of shots from above. And I'm surprised for the quality of the camera too. It's a nice quadcopter, but you see? You see the props the whole time. And it's the yaw is a bit slow, so you cannot make a fast turn. He's drifting. You see, maybe I can show you that with a shot of my action cam. And then maybe you see what I mean with drifting. There he goes. You see? I could not turn it around very quickly, so you have to watch out that you turn around sooner than what you are used to with other drones. But it's a nice drone, and especially for its price, because it's very cheap. I will put a link in the description here under, and that's a link from a GearBest. I bought it by GearBest. I was lucky that it's the sun was shining that day, because you get far more beautiful shots than when it's cloudy. And there stood a little bit of wind that day, but in speed 3 he can handle it with a bit wind. So I'm happy with this quadcopter.